season, the College of Charleston men's basketball program is competing on a Division I level. Now, that's from NAIA competition, and that's a heck of a step up. Many people thought that would be a rough transition for them, but we find out in this story from Greg Peterson that the opposition is the one who was a little bit surprised so far.
Watch him, Adonis. Keep it tight. Keep it tight, Mike. Mike, tight. Tight. Adonis. Good. Grab it. Go. Walk. John, watch the feet, John. Call it Harrisburg, Johnny. All the time, John. Hands. That's your knee. Get him, Kevin. Walk. Kevin. Get up.
Coach John Kress ranting and raving in front of the Cougars bench for more than a dozen years now, learning his craft and his antics from one of the masters.
Of course, in 1979, I was with the infamous Lou Carnesecca, and we had taken a St. John's team three victories into the NCAA tournament, beating Rutgers, Temple, Duke, and then losing by 1 point to Penn, or we would have faced either Magic Johnson in Michigan State or Larry Bird at Indiana State. 3 days later, I'm in Charleston accepting the job and coming as coach of the Cougars into NAIA land. That old gym, I call it a relic, because it was around forever and had a tartan surface, and people started coming the first year. They knew there was a crazy coach in town.
Well, that crazy coach slapped a perennial loser into the NAIA's elite, from the outhouse to the penthouse in 4 short years, leading the Cougars to a national championship in 1983.
We had to play Chaminade, a team that had beaten Ralph Sampson in Virginia, beaten Louisville, and we take them 66-65. And on the fifth game, I had to wash the uniforms every night. I had to make sure the guys were tucked in. And we won on the fifth night. We beat West Virginia Wesleyan for the national title.
A national championship, a new gym, 4 30-win seasons, 9 straight years of at least 20 wins, and John Kress is again eyeing an NCAA prize. The College of Charleston making the transition into the big time, exploding onto the scene this season.
Put instant pressure on ourselves. Instant recognition. We beat UNC Charlotte in the mine shaft, and then Bobby Crimmins, we take that to a 3 or 4 point game near the end, and then this past Saturday against Vanderbilt, we go against the Southeastern team, and Eddie Fogler is quite worried as it's a 3 point game with 50 seconds to go. We lose those two, but we were playing with the big boys. We're playing glamorous teams with a College of Who type team. Who are these people? How can they come close? And who knows, baby? We might be, as Dick Vitale says, in the big show someday. And it could be sooner than people think. Dream come true, postseason play. It's our first year in NCAA Division I. And if we keep it moving in the right direction, I think we're going to be there someday.
First year in NCAA Division I, and 20 wins are in sight. And so, too, a possible NIT bid. Dream come true. I'm Greg Peterson.
Probably one of the best coach teams in the country. They deserve to go to the NIT. They're playing well. They have good athletes.
Kress is doing great, man. Doing a great job, man.
John Kress all the way.
See you in the garden, man. Madison Square Garden. All the way. All right, man.
Okay, enjoy it, man. Enjoy playing. This is a great place to play. For the newcomers, you're going to enjoy this place. The people, okay, always back you. Okay, they love you. The harder you play, the more positive emotion you show, the more they get into the game. okay? It starts with you, okay?
Are you ready?
Looks for a cutter, dribbles left, spots Busby. He'll look to penetrate and pull up on the left side and connect on the running jump shot. 4-2, College of Charleston.
When it came back, you know, we stuck down deep,
man.
Came back.
Yeah, bro.
All I'm gonna say is I'm proud of everybody. Hope you can just keep it up.
Three.